नेक्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट काउंटर फ्लो हीट एक्सचेंजर द वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल इज सेम वी आर गोइंग टू टेक दिस कोल्ड वाटर एंड आउट वाटर इनटू द काउंटर फ्लो डायरेक्शंस राइट द सेम एक्सपेरिमेंटल सेटअप सो देयर इज नो चेंज इनटू द हॉट वाटर डायरेक्शंस एज यूजुअल वी आर टेकिंग इनटू द हॉट वाटर फ्रॉम हियर इनटू द हीट एक्सचेंजर the same procedure we are going to take into the steady state condition up to steady state condition by using this valve we are taking the hot water from this tube the pipe so this outer surfaces the ropes I told you know so it is used to avoid the transfer of heat into the environment condition that is the reason we are using the ropes the hot water as usual we are the water is flowing from this position only we are going to close this valve the entire area from this area to this area only we are going to measure this temperature now the cold water is coming from this direction now we are going to close this valve to avoid this water is flowing from this side so the water is coming from this direction only it is open now we are going to close this valve now. The water is coming from this tube that is pipe so here the water is flowing into the cold water into this direction in this direction right so already I told you know we are having in this pipe that is a 40 mm dia inside of this pipe we are having two pipes one is 12 mm dia and 15 mm dia the 12 mm dia the water hot water is flowing from this direction this is the direction the cold water it is flowing from the 15 mm dia the water is moving from this direction right so that is a counter flow heat exchanger so from this direction the hot water we are measuring from this area from here so in this area only the heat it is transferring from the hot body to cold body so it is in the convection process the transfer of heat it is transferring from solid the copper body to that is a 12 mm body to 15 mm body so it is called counter flow heat exchanger here also we are going to open this process from the point T1 T2 T3 T4 we are going to measure so this is for hot water inlet hot water outlet cold water inlet cold water outlet both we are going to measure for all the four conditions compared to the parallel flow counter flow we are getting better heat transfer so because both these areas it is moving from this side x axis for example if you are taking this is x axis this is another one is reverse directions means the counter flow heat exchanger we are getting more compared to the parallel heat exchanger generally preferably we are using into the counter flow heat exchanger easily it is transferring the heat from the hot water to cold water so that is so this working the calculation part already what we have discussed the same working calculation part from the heat exchanger here also we are going to measure the flow rate as usual QH so what is the value and cold water heat transfer what we have discussed into the previous part that is a parallel flow heat exchanger so here also we are find outing into the LMTD the delta TM means temperature difference of hot water and cold water logarithmic mean temperature difference that is a main concept we are going to measure so LMTD value so if you want to check this so counter flow heat exchanger value we are getting higher than that into the parallel flow so here also we are going to find out into the effectiveness summation that is E is equal to NC into hot water PC into TC not minus TCI divided by MH into PC into THI minus TC this is effectiveness also we are getting higher compared to the parallel flow heat exchanger into the counter flow right so that is this is the results we have discussed we have found out this one the effectiveness of heat exchanger for a counter flow heat exchanger is 0.286 the overall heat transfer coefficient based on inner surface area of heat exchanger is 1.13 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter square the same process the overall heat transfer coefficient based on outer surface area of heat exchanger inner surface and outer surfaces we are getting into this 1.77 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter square so coming to the conclusion parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger both it is possible to transfer the heat from solid that is higher temperature body to lower temperature body but comparatively counter flow heat exchanger we are getting more result compared to the parallel flow heat exchanger that's all